Dun, 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 da, I'm in the kitchen with Chef Andrew Gorski from Elaine's, and we are going to make a delicious dish. Now, I understand, you know, this is an hour-long show, but what we're making today, this is, what did you say, a 48-hour process?
It's like a 3 to 4 day process.
Three to four day process.
Yes, curing foie gras takes a long time.
Okay, so we're going to be doing a foie gras. What goes into making a foie gras? What is it?
Foie gras itself is actually the liver from a duck. Okay. So they actually fatten it before we kill the birds, and we extract the liver. Mm-hmm. We take it, we cure it, we pass it, we turn it into a little terrine, actually.
Okay. So what have we got here? What are we looking at?
So we have pickled here. Peppers. We candy our own blueberries. We make our own house-made fruit roll-ups.
Oh, wow.
We do a air bread. We actually take it in a canister and then microwave it.
Okay.
And then, of course, the four-day process on the foie gras. And we're also using a local farm, Cornucopia, for micros.
Fantastic. All right. Well, we will be back in the kitchen here in just a bit. Trying the foie gras through the magic of television, 3 to 4 days is going to turn into less than 50 minutes. How about that? Right now, let's head over to Brittany. All right, thank you, Britt. We're back in the kitchen with Chef Andrew Gorski of Elaine's. And so during the little tease we had there, you were using this little contraption. What is this?
So it's a canister for NO2. We actually aerate. At Elaine's, we do a little play on brioche, classical brioche, eggs, butter, flour. Mm-hmm. What we're doing here is we're aerating it, and we actually microwave it. It only takes a minute to microwave, and you have bread.
No kidding. So you aerate. How does it get it
within sort of
the,
it blows up the molecules, the butter, the fat, and the eggs.
Okay.
Makes it very aerated. We call it air bread at Elaine's or brioche.
Okay.
As you notice, it's a vehicle for the foie gras, so you're not getting messy while you're eating the foie.
Gotcha. Okay. Can you give us a little demonstration of how this guy works?
Earlier off camera, we mixed up butter, flour, eggs, classical brioche. Mm-hmm. We aerate it, and we put it right into the glass.
Wow.
And we microwave for a minute.
It's amazing. It almost looks like when you're using it, it almost looks like you're doing like insulation or something, like spraying the insulation. That is fantastic. So now, are we going to use this to make the finished product?
We will.
Okay, so we're going to be plating up the foie gras.
Yes.
Of course, we're not preparing it because, as you said, it takes 3 or 4 days.
3 or 4 days.
You know, we're good on TV, but we're not that good. So when we come back, we are going to be plating this up, learning about it. We're going to be talking about a very special event going on at Elaine's and learning more about the restaurant. So stay with us, folks. But for right now, let's head over, check in with meteorologist Cassandra Crimi. So we've been talking about this. Brittany's been practicing pronunciation.
Foie gras.
She got it?
Got it. Nailed it.
She got it. Nailed it. So for those that don't know, Brittany didn't know, I learned this morning, what is foie gras?
Yeah.
So foie gras is the fatty liver of a duck or a goose.
Okay.
It's the byproduct of a feeding process that is given to them.
Okay.
Sometimes it can be on specialized feed, grains, fruits, things like that.
Okay.
This particular foie gras that we use is from Hudson Valley, New York. A very, very great product, something that we appreciate a lot, and that's all we care to use over there.
Okay. And this is something we can get from Elaine's?
Yes,
it is.
Oh,
every day.
Oh, fancy. Shipping it from New York and everything.
That's fantastic. So, We're gonna plate this up here. What's the process of plating this up? Because we're talking about presentation. Presentation is always so key in making this happen.
So in the restaurant during a busy service, speed is key. We try to keep it minimal as far as plating goes. And like I said, this right here is actually the foie lobes.
Uh-huh. Okay.
This is the 4 day process right here. We actually cryovac it so we keep it from oxidizing.
Okay.
So that is meat.
It's liver.
It's liver. Yeah. Liver.
It's like a pate,
that's a big
so
liver.
Okay.
This is a combination of four livers.
Okay.
After we've been cured, and like I said, it goes into a terrine mold.
Okay.
So after we do the four livers, the finished mold is about this big.
No kidding.
Oh,
wow.
Wow.
Okay.
And is it only duck liver?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, it's butter. It's essentially butter.
It's essentially butter. Okay.
Oh,
now, is it...
See how smooth it sliced when he went through
it? Is it something that really is... Is it more of a dessert? Something that you finish up with?
Well, there's sweet aspects of the plate. Obviously, the blueberries have been pickled in a simple syrup.
Okay.
The peppers themselves are naturally sweet. Okay. So, yeah, if you want to go with dessert...
Okay, if you want to go with dessert, whatever you fancy, that's great.
Are those sprouts?
Yeah, these are opal basil sprouts that we get from Cornucopia Farms in South Valley.
Okay.
Wow, great. So I like that, local,
yes,
organic,
local,
that's
and they
fantastic.
Do a great job. They've been around for about a year now, and they're fantastic.
That's great. So tell us a bit about Elaine's. We've never eaten there. What can we expect?
So Elaine's is a intimate 52-seat restaurant, upscale.
Very, very different than anything else probably that you'll find on Central or maybe even in Albuquerque.
Okay.
You walk in, you don't have a grand area. You know, you're kind of seated almost banquet style with people in the restaurant. Everything is very close and quaint.
Uh-huh.
So you can almost strike conversation with the people sitting next to you.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, it's a very nice
spot. It's like a community restaurant.
Yeah, we have a very nice little wine bar. We do beer and wine over there. And we're open Tuesday through Saturday.
Okay, fantastic. Now, there is something coming up very quickly that I want to mention. We'll talk about this process here. Taylor's Calling going on. You guys are working with the Albuquerque Film and Media Experience on a very important organization. Taylor's Calling, it really is to raise awareness of heroin addiction. One of the founders of AFME, Larry Michaels, his son Taylor passed away, I believe, a year ago, unfortunately, due to this. And so the folks at AFME, always doing great work here in the Duke City, are honoring his memory and preventing this from happening with other people. So you guys are going to be hosting a charity event on that. We, of course, will have links at CASA.com for this and links to AFME. But in the meantime, so we've got the bread here, which looks pretty cool. It's the Leaning Tower of Pisa, as you can see. The Leaning Tower of Bread.
So that is bread. Okay.
Yeah, it is bread.
Is that what you, with this thing?
That is what we made in that canister. It goes from here to the cup, to the microwave for 1 minute.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it rises all the way to the top of the cup. Mm-hmm. We cool it sitting reversed so that it doesn't smash after it's rose.
Okay. Oh, okay.
And we want it to have a little whimsical look about it. So if it's leaning to one side or it the does. Other, it's
it
even
does.
Better.
Okay, and then is that a fruit roll-up?
That
it is. We make it in-house with fresh blueberries.
Oh, so it's like a healthier.
Yeah,
healthier
there's no corn syrup in it.
There's no corn syrup. That's important. How do you make a fruit roll-up?
Well, there's enough natural
pectin. Other than going to the store and buying it.
There's enough natural pectin in the skins of the blueberries, so it actually sets itself up. We just add a little bit of pure honey to it, and we dehydrate it for about 4 hours.
Okay.
We add a little bit of canola oil, just so it doesn't stick to your teeth while you eat it.
Oh, okay. Okay. Do you just make these at home and sit there and munch on them?
My kids love them.
I bet. Absolutely. All right. So, again, remind us where Lanes is located.
We're at 3503 Suite B on Central Avenue.
Okay.
Just across the street from Scala Northern Italian Grill.
Oh, great. Okay. Very easy. Right there in the heart of Knob Hill. Fantastic. And for more information on Lanes, head over to CASA.com. You can click on the style tab. We'll have links there. When we come back, we're going to try this.
Yeah, we are.
We're going to try some foie gras. Hit me with it.
Foie gras.
There you go. Foie gras. Stay with us, folks.